Okay, let's get started. Before we start, I have some questions. How many people here are running on OpenStack Cloud right now? Okay. How many of you have the plan to upgrade your OpenStack Cloud in the next 1 or 2 years? Okay, great. And how many of you are the contributors to the committee, either the core products or the developer, the drivers for Neutron Cinder or NOAA? Okay, great. I think we got the right people in this room. Thank you. So let's get started. For this session, we'll introduce OpenStack upgrade without downtime. That's how to rolling upgrade your OpenStack environments. See it work. Okay, here we go. So for today's agenda, we will have a general introduction about the Lab 5 grid, and then I will turn over to Takashi, and he will introduce how NTT designed the testing of the Lab 5 grid and how to do that with the upgrade procedures. And also, he will share the test results in the 2 rounds of testing. And in the last, we will have a summary about the issues we have during the testing. And also, we want to call for help from the committee to do some improvements. So the first of all, we want to introduce who we are. Takeshi, you want to have a self-introduction?
Hello, everyone. My name is Takashi Natsume. I work for NTT Corporation. Thank you for coming today.
OK, for myself, I'm Ian Kalu. I'm from Canonical. And I worked with the Takashi team to provide the consulting service for them for this project. So for the OpenStack upgrade, why do you want to upgrade without the downtime? I think this is some reasons coming from, especially you deploy your OpenStack in a production environment, or you deploy it to provide the public cloud service. The first of all is OpenStack has a release every half a year. How do you catch up? How do you to make sure you can get the latest features from the OpenStack you need to upgrade? And also, for example, if you have an environment which is deployed on the Fersom or Grizzly, I think now the code is already out of maintenance. You have to maintain it by yourself. There's a lot of maintenance costs you need to consider. And in addition, there are a couple of ways you can do the upgrade. You can upgrade using an offline upgrade, build another environment, and migrate all your resources eventually. But it needs to invest the new hardwares. So this introduced additional cost. So in this session, we will introduce how we upgrade the OpenStack environment from Havana to Aspenhaus in the same testing environment. So before the project start, I think NTT team, they set up their goals for the Lab upgrade. The first goal is there is no impact on the existing results. The existing results, including the instances the customers already deployed and they are using, or even they have some connections to that to their instance right now, and also the resources, including the storage, volume storages, and also we don't want to introduce any performance problem during the upgrading process. So the second goal of the NTT Cloud Lab 5 grid is there's no impact for the new requests. For example, if I want to requires a new instance. I want to create a new volume. But right now, the upgrade is in progress. We don't want that to impact the end users. So, but how we do that? That's why NTT team started a test project. They deploy the test environment, follow the exactly the same architecture in their production environment, and they conduct maybe two to three months testing in this environment, and they defined what component we need to consider for the upgrade, including the OpenStack core components, NOAA, CinderGlance, Neutron, Keystone, and Heat. But what I want to highlight here for the other OpenStack components are the middlewares underlying, for example, the MySQL, or their directories, their load balance service, and also the OpenStack, the operation system itself is not considered in this product. So the test is conducted from Havana stable to Icehouse 1. That's because at that time, this Icehouse 1 is the only released version when the testing was started. And later on, we found some bugs during the upgrade, which was fixed in Icehouse 3. So for NOAA upgrading, rolling upgrade, we upgraded to the Icehouse 3 in the second round testing. So a bit of background information about the system architecture. If you take a look on this overall system architecture, we separate the services which can support active availability, and the services can support active passive availability. Also, the services have no HA solution right now. So this separation, the reason is we need to take the different strategy for the upgrade for these components. So another thing I want to mention here is for the network solution, NTT takes the VMware and NSX in this testing. It's not the normal Neutron something. It's Neutron plus the NSX. And for the storage, block storage, in this architecture, we take the EMC storage driver during the testing. So now I will like to hand over to Takesh to introduce some details.
From now, I will explain our live upgrade testing. We NTT performed a feasibility study for live upgrade in our test environment. Step-by-step upgrade, rolling upgrade, was needed in order to satisfy our goal that Yankai mentioned. Because the way to upgrade the entire system at one time affects users' resource utilization and users' API calls. On the premise of it, I will explain our trial from the viewpoint of these five items. At first, I would like to talk about things to be investigated before creating upgrade procedure. We investigated these three items by checking OpenStack source codes. As you know, there is a possibility that the database schema is changed in new version. And the consistency of APIs between components is also important. Components means NOVA, Cinder, and so on. For example, check API versions consistency in calling from NOVA to Cinder. And the consistency of RPC APIs and REST APIs in each component should be checked. For example, RPC APIs versions consistency in calling from Cinda API to Cinda volume. When it comes to RPC API, major version is very important. About this matter, I will explain the details later. Then I will explain considerations in creating upgrade procedures. User resources must be transferred from upgrade target host to another host. In our case, user resources were VM instances, block storages, virtual routers, and virtual networks. These resource migration steps must be added into the procedure. For example, VM instances have to be transferred by live migration and so on. But Cinda's volume migration was not utilized in our trial. As a factor that determines the order to upgrade in each component, there is RPC API versions. Errors occur in case that the major version query supports and RPC messages major version are different. When major versions are same, it is no problem in case of the minor version query supports equals or greater than RPC messages minor version. But if the former is less than the latter, errors occur. In this figure, if RPC major versions are same, a caller has to be upgraded after a query is upgraded. In this case, upgrade is performed in the order of process A, process B, process C. In other words, the order of upgrade must be decided so that there is no contradiction among RPC API versions. And we also have to decide the upgrade order of OpenStack components on the basis of consistency of APIs between components. And you should consider the way to block requests to check processes in progress and utilizing aggressive shutdown function. About changing database schema, in Nova upgrade procedure designed in the community, database schema is upgraded at once, and Nova conductor processes are also upgraded at once. This procedure didn't meet our requirements. So, in our procedure, in order to avoid API call interruption, controllers are rolling upgraded. Therefore, OpenStack processes coexist on different versions. In order to enable it, at the beginning, add new version tables, add new version columns, and add new version indexes. Then, upgrade OpenStack processes. In the end, delete all the version tables, delete all the version columns, and delete all the version indexes. In our trial, it was not needed to convert data format, but it must be considered in some cases. And database lock time will be a long time if large number of records exist in database tables. But we did not write our procedure with large number of records. In that case, these tools will be able to solve the issue. About high availability configuration, from the perspective of live upgrade, active-active configuration is desirable. But there are some cases that active-active cannot be configured, so active standby is forced. For example, the case that Cinder backend or Neutron plugin does not support active-active configuration. In our test environment, Nova console auth and heat engine were also configured active standby. Neutron L3 agent and Neutron DHCP agent were configured active-active in our test environment. It means that nodes hosts were configured active-active. But essentially, these processes should have been configured active standby because they have their own state. In latest version, heat has multiple engine function. So heat engine processes would be configured active-active. Now, and Neutron has L3 agent HA BRRP function now. In active-active configuration case, requests to the target host are blocked at the load balancer while the target host is upgraded. When switching active standby, there is a service downtime of the component as expected. By the HA configuration, the live upgrade is performed in these procedures. We had three patterns. In active-active configuration, steps are block requests connections to upgrade target host, migrate user resources, upgrade host, and unblock. These series of steps are repeated on each host. In active standby configuration, steps are upgrade standby host, block request to active host if possible, switch active standby, and unblock. These series of steps are also repeated on each host. In no HA configuration, Nova compute hosts, steps are block request to target host, migrate users resources, upgrade host, and unblock. These are also repeated on each host. This figure is one shown earlier. This was our test environment. Based on that, we explained, especially by considering upgrade steps of each HA configuration and RPC API versions, we created the overall upgrade procedure. This is overall upgrade procedure. At first, backup database and change database schema. Then, rolling upgrade is performed on each host in order. by considering RPC API versions. For example, Cinder volume is upgraded before Cinder API, Cinder scheduler, controllers are upgraded. And Heat Engine is upgraded before Heat API is upgraded. About Nova, controllers, Nova API, Nova scheduler, Nova conductor are upgraded before Nova compute. As you know, Compute API major version was up in Ice House release. But Stable Havana Nova Compute, Stable Havana Nova Compute can understand Ice House level 3.0 messages. So it can be upgraded in that order. When live migration is performed from Havana node to Ice House node, Ice House Nova Compute cannot understand Havana level messages because of major version difference. So Havana Nova Compute has to be set Ice House compat at upgrade levels section in NovaConf. It enables Havana Nova Compute to send Ice House level messages. And there are active configuration hosts, active standby hosts, and single no HA hosts. They are upgraded by following the steps explained in the previous slide. At last, database is backed up and the data schema is changed. About test tools, we placed a load on our test environment during live upgrade procedure test. The loads were API requests covered patterns of calls between components and between processes in each component in our use case. North, South and East-West network communication and VNC console connection. About test environment, it was mandatory that the environment has the same configuration, especially high availability configuration, as same as the production environment to be applied upgrade procedure. And we tested our procedure in the environment that was got back easily by using Chef. We tested our procedure and identified issues by these criteria. Criteria were whether our procedure satisfy our goal or not, and whether inconsistency between database records and substances occurred or not. And we checked the step that takes a long time. As a result that we tried our procedure, we found these issues. The bug about heat graceful shutdown function has been fixed by NTT team. And about remaining issues, these items were issues we cannot solve. The first one is errors due to active standby failover. They were resource creation failures. The second one is errors due to mismatch of RPC API major versions. The error was unsupported RPC version. In latest calls, it would be unsupported RPC envelope version. This error occurred from Nova Compute to Nova Console OS and from Nova Node ENC proxy to Nova Console OS. It was unavoidable because RPC API major versions could not be changed. The third one is communication interruption on Neutron L3 agent. About communication interruption on Neutron L3 agent, at first, we had an issue that user requests to create a new router were assigned to the upgrade target host. In order to solve the issue, we set admin state map of Neutron L3 agent to false. It solved the scheduler issue, but another issue occurred. It was communication interruption. But this issue would be solved in Juno release by using L3 agent HA function. But we have not tried it yet. And when VM live migration or Nova NoVNC proxy upgrade was performed, interruption of the console connection also occurred. About fallback, it was impossible to fallback after changing DB schema at the beginning. About the resulting knowledge, a clean installation was needed in OpenStack components installation because there is a possibility to cause errors if overwritten install was performed. Then, Yankai will wrap up our presentation.
Oh, thank you, Takesh. So I will do a quickly summary. So I think for the left upgrade, our goal is to achieve 1% left upgrade without service downtime. But it's still difficult to achieve that when you do the upgrading from Havana to Icehouse. I think the issues we found is about network downtime, because there's no high ability, active high ability provided for Neutron L3 agent. You have to have a trade-off. Either you stop the new request to create new networks, or then migrate the router from one network node to another network node one by one, or you need to block one network node and then to make sure the scheduler works well, but there will be interruption for the other VMs, for the VMs with the VRouter on that network node. So another issue we found, or a general issue, is that some API requests will be failed if there's a failover between the active and the standby components. And another one is about the VNC console. During the upgrade, if there's a VNC console, it will be disconnected. I know there's discussions about how to keep the seamless console by SPICE, but I don't think it's already implemented right now. So basically, here is our suggestions for the community. So if you think about the whole upgrade procedures or the strategy, I think there are two key things you need to consider. The first one is the active HA for all the components. This is very important. You can do the live upgrade. The other one is how you make sure the two versions components can coexist and providing service when you're doing the upgrade. So in this case, the RPC version will be very important to have to support the rolling upgrade. So also, I know there are some plugins or drivers provided by the vendor companies, either for Neutron or Cinder. But when you, for example, you provide SDN controller, for the Neutron server API itself is provide active HA, but maybe because I need to use this SDN controller, it breaks the active HA. So that's another issue we found during this testing. Basically, in this testing, we didn't cover the centimeter. And also, I know there are some design sessions for the Cinder rolling upgrade, heat rolling upgrade, Nova rolling upgrade, something like that from today to tomorrow. So I expect there will be more improvements to benefit all the end users. Also, in this topic, we didn't cover if you have the Nova network, how you migrate to the Neutron, or if you have the Ice House Neutron, the legacy router, how you migrate to the DVR distributed virtual router. So this is, I think that there are a lot of future works to do. But for the NTT public cloud, we expect to deploy the production environment in Juno, and we plan to have another round of testing from Juno to Kilo. In that case, we want to achieve much better result than this round of testing. Thank you. So any questions?
No. One more page.
Yeah. One more page? Oh, this is reference. Documents.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Yeah. So we will have several minutes for the questions. Yeah. Okay, good. No questions. It's lunch time. Okay, thank you all.
Sorry.
Yeah. So right now you're running on Ice House. Have you guys already started looking at moving to Juno? And what things do you see right now that you're going to be looking as issues? Or have you thought about that yet?
The issue?
Yeah, of trying to go
from... A general issue will be the RPC API consistency. Mm. You need to double check. Another one is the Neutron. If you want to take the advantage of the L3 agent HA or the DVR, that's a different design, a different implementation. How you migrate from the legacy router Neutron to a new Neutron design, that's another big problem you need to consider. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. So.